those words when I was a first grader. Mrs. Gordon was my first grade teacher, and she was a tall, statuesque blonde with perfectly coiffed hair. And she was my favorite teacher. And we had a parent-teacher conference, and she used those words to describe me. And those words, I believe, had an impact on my entire life. When you're a child, your teacher is held at such high esteem. So whatever Mrs. Gordon said, I believed it to be true. So her words were encouraging, they were empowering, and they gave me a lot of self-confidence. Those words even survived some negative advice that I had gotten from a counselor years later. So fast forward about 10 years. I grew up in Long Island, New York, and I moved to California. And I went to West Covina High School as a freshman in high school. And I settled in really well. I loved the school, I enjoyed the people. I got very involved with extracurricular activities, including gymnastics and band. Well, senior year rolled around, and it was time to think about what we're gonna do with our lives after high school. And we were encouraged to talk to our guidance counselors and get some advice from them. And I had hoped that my guidance counselor would give me some tricks and tips to filling out college applications. I had decided that I wanted to go to Stanford University. And so I told my counselor that. And despite the fact I was the top 10 in the class, her comment to me was, "My advice to you, Melissa, is go to a community college, get your feet wet, you feel more comfortable there, and then later, if you choose, you should go ahead and apply to college." She was tall, and she was blonde also, but she wasn't Mrs. Gordon. She wasn't empowering. She wasn't encouraging. And I just didn't understand those words. If they didn't make sense to me. And people who have places of authority, like guidance counselors or teachers, can really tear down a student if they don't have had the help from others to support them and to build self-confidence in them. I really feel that a teacher is one of the most influential people in a child's life. More so than parents, a teacher spends probably half of that child's waking hours instructing them, teaching them, if they're a good teacher, encouraging them. Parents, on the other hand, they have to stop their kids from sibling fights, and they have to tell Johnny to finish eating his dinner, or they have to take their children to dance lessons or soccer practice. But teachers are there for our students. And so I want to share with you a story about a teacher who was exceptional in that she believed in her students. She held the standards very high, and she encouraged them that indeed they could meet those standards. They could do anything they set their mind to. The story is of Marva Collins. And maybe some of you have heard her story before, but she was a student teacher in the worst district of the notoriously bad Chicago public education system. And although she was a student teacher, and she was a black student teacher, she had an opportunity to teach a class for almost a whole semester because a teacher had gone off on maternity leave. And so when she came to the school, she wasn't really given much instruction. She was given a folder that had some information in it about the students and was basically told to teach. So she was nervous, but she was excited, really looking forward to this opportunity. And she opened up the folder, and on the left class. And then on the right side, it had their IQ numbers. Her IQ numbers, their IQ numbers. And so she was really amazed at the caliber of students. 126, 137, 140. She goes, I got a class of geniuses here. So, of course, she felt a little pressure on herself to really do well. She had a group of very smart children, and she needed to make sure that they met their potential. And so she taught them, and she was very challenging to them. She would set a challenge here, and when they met it, she'd increase it higher, and they would meet it. And she encouraged them that they could do anything they set their mind to. And she was tough on them, but she also encouraged them and empowered them and told them they could do great things. She nurtured them. Well, it was near the end of the semester, and the principal made a visit to her classroom. She was a little nervous because she realized that the standardized test results were probably in by now. And she was just hoping that her class had done really well. Well, her fears were calmed because the principal said that her class had done phenomenally on the standardized tests. And in fact, he wanted to understand what her teaching method was so that he could share that with others, for the other, you know, the other faculty. So she was relieved, of course, that everything went well and the students did well as she had expected. But she felt like she needed to remind the principal that, you know, most of the kids in the class were geniuses. You probably expect that they do well on this standardized test. And the principal looked at her and he didn't really understand what she meant. And she says, well, let me pull out the folder. And she showed their names and the associated IQ scores. And the principal had to smile. And he shook his head and he said, he put his arm around her. And he said, Mrs. Little, those aren't IQ scores, those are their locker numbers. I feel like I should just drop the mic right now, but I don't want any of us to drop the ball. One of Mrs. Little's famous quotes was, there is a brilliant child locked inside every student. And I say, there's a brilliant mentor or role model locked inside every one of us. So I challenge you and I charge you with inspiring a young child, encouraging a young child. That may mean going to their school. That may mean contacting the guidance counselor at a school. That may mean joining a club that mentors children. And in conclusion, I would encourage all of you to work with a child, and even better, an at-risk child, and make sure that you encourage them and tell them that they can be whoever they want to be, and you be that role model, you be that mentor.